one of the greatest love stories in all of British literature is that of Robert Browning and Elizabeth Barrett Browning, who lived in a house on this site. Elizabeth Barrett was an invalid most of her life. She was the daughter of a pathologically overprotective father. He didn't want any of his children to marry, and he kept Elizabeth as a virtual prisoner in this house. From her upstairs room, Elizabeth wrote and published poetry and carried on a voluminous correspondence with various people in the arts.
Wimpole Street is Elizabeth Barrett's famous address. Robert Browning was from the other side of London, south of the River Thames, in an area destroyed in World War II. Robert Browning had a difficult start in his writing career. He wrote poems and plays that received terrible reviews. The reviews were very discouraging to him.
Robert Browning began publishing a series of poems and plays called Bells and Pomegranates. Elizabeth Barrett read his work and wrote about it in one of her own poems. Or, from Browning, some pomegranate, which if cut deep down the middle, shows a heart blood-tinctured of a veined humanity. Browning was overwhelmed by this line, feeling that at last he had found someone who understood him and his poetry. He immediately began writing to her and even proposed before they'd ever met. Eventually, he did visit her in her room, where she occasionally received visitors. The letters they sent back and forth are some of the most famous love letters ever written. Eventually, Robert persuaded Elizabeth to marry him. Because of her father, she had to sneak out of the house with the help of one of her sisters and her maid, and fainting several times along the way, she traveled the few blocks to Marylebone Church, where they were married.
This is the Browning's marriage license, which is on display in Marylebone Church. This is the exterior of Marylebone Church in London. In addition to displaying the Browning's marriage license, the church has a room which it's dedicated to the Brownings to commemorate the fact that they were married in this church. In the Browning room, you will find a stained glass window noting the date of the Browning's marriage, as well as plaques depicting Elizabeth and Robert Browning.
The story is often portrayed as the romantic story of a young girl defying her father to marry her true love, but at the time of the marriage, Elizabeth was 40 years old. Immediately after the wedding ceremony here in Marylebone Church, Elizabeth returned to her house and Robert to his. He began making plans for them to leave London, and several days later they left to live in Italy. I'm sure all of you have heard the famous opening lines of Elizabeth Barrett Browning's sonnet 43. How do I love thee? Let me count the ways. I love thee to the depth, breadth, and height my soul can reach. But the poem The Cry of the Children presents a very different side of the poet, a concern for the political and social issues of her time.